Yeah, hi there. These comments are for M. I'm just using the first letter of your name for privacy purposes, and I am Michael, the founder, owner, and the materials writer for all of your lessons at the TOEFL online course called The 7-Step System to Pass a TOEFL IBT. And you just made some comments. I think you sent me an email, and I want to go ahead and try to address some of your concerns right now. So you say, actually, I'm trying to pass the TOEFL IBT for more than 1 year, but unfortunately, I did not achieve yet. I immigrated from Iran to Canada about 2 months ago, and guess what? Now you're getting English only all day long. This is going to be good for you. Make sure you're watching a lot of TV in English, listen to the radio in English, and Canada has millions of English speakers. Speak English as much as you can. This is very important. So you say, I took the TOEFL exam twice, first in December 2012 in Iran, and the second in March 2012 in Canada, but in all my skills are exactly the same except listening. I was studying for the second exam for almost 8 months just by myself, using tutorial videos and TOEFL books and so on. You say, I am really disappointed now. I don't know what to do. I need 98 to get admission. For a PhD degree, I got 74 in my first exam. You got 17 on the reading, 18 in the listening, 19 on the speaking, 20 on the writing. And then you say, I got 78 in my second exam. In this case, you scored 17 on the reading, 22 on the listening, 19 on the speaking, and 20 on the writing. You say, I have to say, You want to say here, I was distracted by another test taker in the listening section, so maybe my score in that part must have been a bit higher, around 24. Needless to say, I need your help. I found you on YouTube. I'm looking forward to hearing from you. All right, we can do this. So, what do I recommend for you? Okay. I think there's three recommendations I want to give you right now. You might want to write these down. Remember what I said in the very beginning of the video? You are now living in an English-speaking country. That means you're watching TV in English, you're listening to the radio in English, you're speaking English all day long. This is your first rule right here. If you want to get over 100 or 98 on the TOEFL, you're going to have to make English a primary part of your life right now. Now, once you reach the TOEFL and you want to speak Farsi or Persian again, no problem. But you got to focus a lot on English right now until you realize your goal. So, number one suggestion. Get in the habit or stay in the habit of reading for about 1 hour every day for the next few months. You want to read magazines, newspapers, and then books. Not just short articles, but it's good for you to read longer type things. If you get a book that's 300 pages long, it's got 8 or 9 or 10 chapters in it, read it. This is good for you. Trust me. Number two, you also want to spend about the same amount of time each day practicing listening. You can focus on news, history, documentary, and most importantly, you guessed it, science programs. This is very important for you. Now, as you're doing your reading and your listening practice, get in the habit of note-taking. Focus on the main and the most important supporting points of those reading and listening passages. Then, using your notes, you can orally summarize the information, in which case you're practicing your integrated speaking, or you can use your notes to write a summary, in which case you're practicing your TOEFL integrated writing. So that's kind of what I would recommend. Those are my first two suggestions. Now, if you don't have access to TV programs in English, I mean, hopefully you do, but you can also use the internet. I'll give you two great websites for listening practice. One, it's called nationalpublicradio.org. NPR.org, it is. www.npr.org. National Public Radio. The second website is called TED Talks. Two words. TED, TED, then Talks. TALKS. Both of those websites will give you some very good practice with listening. Now, if you do these two things, this is almost 2 hours every day. You want to do this for at least 3 months. This is very, very important. You must make this a priority. Now, my third suggestion, I'm going to recommend right now over, you can go to my IBT TOEFL study guides. If you go back to my website, and on this one, to go from 74 to 98 is going to take some time. Now, it may take longer than 90 days, but I'm going to recommend my 90-day online TOEFL study guide focusing on vocabulary, pronunciation, grammar, listening, reading, writing, and speaking areas. So now we got 1 hour a day reading, 1 hour a day listening. Spend 2 hours using my 90-day TOEFL study guide. Now we got about 4 hours every day for the next 90 days. This is some very serious English study. You got to get your calendar out, and you got to plan your days accordingly. It's very important to try to study every day. Don't say, well, Michael, I'm going to study 8 hours on Saturday and 8 hours on Sunday to make up for some of the days I missed during the week. It's better to study every day, to have regular contact with the language. All right, so those are my recommendations, and thank you very much for your comments. I really hope that you can solve your academic English language problem soon, so you don't have to worry as much about the TOEFL, because you know, if you get a PhD degree, guess what? You're going to have a lot more respect, a lot more power, you're going to make a lot more money. This is going to put you in a very, very good position, right? So to help you realize that goal, trust me, if you do these three suggestions, this is going to really, really help you improve your academic English language proficiency. Not just for TOEFL, but as you're doing your PhD degree, you'll find yourself doing much better when you're doing your writing and your reading assignments, when you're participating in class with oral discussions and giving presentations and all those things. My course is going to help you. Even the reading part of my course is going to help you increase your reading speed to 350 words per minute. How much time do you think that's going to save when you're in your PhD program and you have to read hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of books and magazines and articles and so on? All right, thank you.